I'm excited because I just got another piece of kit in the mail today. A sheet of cotton. And not just any sheet of cotton, but a green screen. You might remember how my channel looked and sounded when I started several months ago. My setting was okay, but my audio was terrible due to poor room acoustics and having the wrong microphone. I set up a studio of sorts in my basement due to better acoustics, but lighting and visuals were poor. I quickly got to work to fix the lighting and purchased a Muslim backdrop as a quick fix to the problem. While the backdrop looked better than an unfinished basement with concrete and styrofoam, the color was not the best and I was getting bored of the look. I wanted to try out a green screen. A green screen allows me to preview backdrops quickly and get the best look. Try doing this with a Muslin. It's very time consuming and frustrating trying to get the right look, and you can't tell if the backdrop looks good until you're in post-production. Editing raw footage is the easiest part of working with green screens. The first thing you need to do is set up your studio space. Green screens can go horribly wrong if your studio is not set up properly. The green screen should hang from the ceiling to the floor, preferably against a wall with no windows. Don't worry about removing wrinkles. I hung mine immediately after unboxing, wrinkles and all. Follow the next few steps and you won't have to worry about wrinkles at all. Place an X on the floor about 7 to 8 feet in front of the green screen. That's where you'll be standing. Being this far forward will allow the camera to optimally blur the background. Your camera should be anywhere from 3 to 9 feet in front of you, depending on the lens and sensor size. I'm using a Canon 70D with a 51.2 lens, so my camera needs to be about 9 feet in front of me. Depending on your lens and camera, adjust the distance to get the look that you need. Light yourself with a ceiling-mounted light. Set the temperature to 5600. If you can't mount a light from the ceiling, use a ring light around the camera. The light should not be more than about 4 feet in front of you, or it will not be effective. Set two lights onto the green screen off from the side. They should be back from the screen by about 3 feet diagonally. This will eliminate any shadows cast from the main light. Set their color temperature to 3300. Once we have all the raw footage in Final Cut, it's very simple to remove that green screen background. The footage I've laid out here is actually the footage for this video. In the first three clips, we don't have a background. So let's go ahead and apply a background and see how that looks. I think I'm going to have a bit of a problem right here. So let's go bring the background in. And I'll just bring it over. Now, to remove the green screen, I need to use an effect. So let's go over and open up the effects section. And I'm looking for keying right here. So I'm going to go ahead and take the keyer and bring it down to the first clip. So we can see that the green screen has been completely removed. My background image doesn't completely stretch, so we need to use the transformation tool. And we just want to drag it till it fills the entire screen. Looks pretty good. Right about, yeah, that looks good. No, no. There we go. Click done. So to fix this issue here that we have in this corner, I'm going to go over to the keyer. I'm going to use the map view. And with the map view, you can see it's actually a pretty clean image. It's just that lower corner. So the way to fix that, choose sample color. I'm just going to draw a small little rectangle until it's gone. Perfect. Looks good. Okay, let's switch back to the composite view. That looks perfect. Now what I can actually do is I can copy this clip and then do Shift Command V, and I can actually copy over the transformation as well as the keying. I don't want to copy over the white balance though. So there we go, fix there too, that looks good. Let's just do a test with the mat. Yep, looks good. And our next clip, same thing. Shift Command V. And just remove balance, because that's already been fixed. And look how perfect that is. Looks really, really good. Now, the other thing you might want to do here is you might want to come down to the background, because it looks like I'm right there, right close to the background. It seems a little claustrophobic. But I can add a bit of a depth by using another effect. So let's bring that effect over to the background. Now, it's a little bit too blurred out, so I'm going to adjust that a little bit. I'm going to reduce the amount way down to about there. So you can see what it looked like without it, a little bit too sharp. And that's giving it a sort of a nice blurred background so it doesn't look like I'm right there. And that's, I think that looks pretty good. We still have a little bit of work to do. If you look at the edge around me, it looks a little artificial. There's still a little bit of green there. So what I want to do is I want to soften it a little bit. And I want to remove that green. So under Keyer, we're going to go to Matte Tools. Now, I've already set the levels to 0.3. And I like that. That really kind of that helps to soften it a little bit. But what we really need to do here is use the softener. Let's drag that to about there. But let's shrink the matte a little bit. Perfect. Well, let's see the problem. If we shrink it too far, we're going to end up with holes in the mat. And that won't look good. So we don't have any holes. Good. And have we softened it too much? Just want to do it just a little bit. Overdo it and it just doesn't look natural. See? So you can see my shirt, you see those little black holes? That's because we've shrunk it too far. There, that's better. So you'll notice now, I don't have that green R around me and it's got a softer edge. Looks a little more natural. Green screens are a lot of fun to work with. They're easy to set up. The real expense is in the lighting and the rigging. While it's possible to do green screens with fewer lights and standing closer to the screen itself, you might end up with unwanted results that require additional work in post-production. If you have any questions at all regarding this video or any of my content, drop me a comment down below. I usually get back to you guys within 24 hours. If you'd like to get notification of new videos as they're published, click subscribe and then immediately click that notification icon and all, and you'll get notified when I publish new videos. Thank you so much for tuning in. I look forward to seeing you soon.